kind of switch my instrument panel on. Yeah, there's something in front of me.
Wow. What scatter is that?
That's okay. Whoever was in my way is out of my way now.
Отцепка 2900.
Yeah, my time was set at 5 p.m. when I came in the sim.
Yep. Yeah, almost double check.
How's the habit of doing that?
So June in Colombia, that's not summer there, is it? It's like fall or spring?
Yeah, I suppose that would be true, yes.
Good evening.
Hello.
Evening.
Sorry, radio check.
Check, 1, 2. I'm in a thermal if anybody wants to join.
Yeah, that's why I got the thermal when I tried a takeoff actually earlier. And that's where I'm heading. Going clockwise, yes?
Yes.
Did B21 suggested we set our MacCready to 2, is that correct?
2 meters per second or 4 knots.
So in the Captain Bilbo mode, it says, you know, it's... What is it in meters per second or knots per second? Or it's what you're setting to your...
If your airspeed is displayed in knots, then for sure the rest is also knots.
Okay, so that should be 4. The MacCready set to 4, is that correct?
Correct.
Thank you.
Does the maximum on your go to 10? If it goes to 10, that's usually knots.
Bit of a wonky question here, but what does the MacCready do?
The MacCready tells your glide computer how fast you think you will be flying today. So if you're expecting really good conditions, you set a high MacCready setting. So then all the arrival height calculation and the speed to fly indication will be based on that MacCready. So basically you're telling your computer, I want to fly at a certain speed, right? Your speed to fly. Like if you want to go really fast, you fly at the speed to fly of 120 knots or so. And of course you will lose altitude quicker that way. That's how your arrival height calculation is going to factor that in. Did that make sense?
Yeah, right. Thank you very much. That's actually a match up. Thank you.
Cool.
So like an emergency, get back to the field, you would use 0, in other words.
Yeah.
Or in bad conditions.
So you should be, should I be changing that often? Because I've never really touched it, I've kind of just left it at 0 every time I fly.
It depends on the conditions, right? So if you know on a certain leg you will have good conditions, aka you will know where you find lift, then you can set a high MacCready setting. But then if you're on a leg where you know there's not a lot of lift sources, that means you will probably planning to fly slower. In that case, you will reduce the MacCready to something lower.
All right, thank you very much.
So in real life, in real competition, I thought they were giving you sort of an idea of what your MacCready should be set at, instead of you changing it during your flight. So did I misunderstand that?
I'm not sure about that.
When I asked B21 about it, he said it's set at the same for the entire flight. And that you don't typically change it throughout the flight based on conditions, so. But that's just not
also, the LXN mod has an auto MacCready setting, which can really mess with you if you're trying to set it.
Oh, it adjusts on its own based on the past conditions or something?
Yeah, on your last thermal.
it's up to the pilot to decide what MacCready settings he uses, not up to the competition director.
That's right.
Exactly. 14 knots over here, that's pretty good.
Who's up? Let's see.
Auto.
So who was that saying is 14 knots? Where?
Auto Pepper over here, 14 knots. Here.
Sorry, thanks.
So in my units of measurements options, my speed is set to kilometers per hour, so I should set my MacCready to 2 meters per second instead of 4 knots. Is that's correct?
Which guide are you flying?
I'm flying the GG808 with the Captain Bilbo mode.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember how it is. If you go to your settings page, you can click on units of measurement, then you will see it.
Yeah, so I have under speed, I'm set in kilometers per hour.
Ah, yeah, there's no MacCready in those settings, I see now. I'm assuming it's always knots. So I'm set to 4.
4, although my speed is set to kilometers per hour, correct?
Yeah. You can double check what your speed to fly is saying. If you set it MacCready at 4, your speed to fly should be saying 118 knots. Or whatever that is in kilometers per hour.
Yeah, so it says 228, so that's probably kilometers per hour, so okay.
Yeah.
Why does mine say 135 and a MacCready of 4 speed to fly?
Which glider?
Is it Imperial?
I'm on the JS3 now.
Yeah. And I remember last flight also B-21's speed of flight was a different one from mine. It's just different flight model, I guess, and maybe also slightly different calculation.
Willem, are you flying the GG808, Willem?
I am.
I've never flown it.
Also, make sure to adjust your barometer in the JS3 and every other glider, probably. If you just press B, then some numbers might change.
So actually, my wind speed is set in knots, so that's probably why I need my MacCready set to knots.
Exactly.
It's not the speed, it's the wind speed that matters, the units for the wind speed.
Depends if you haven't set them Imperial or metric.
Imperial.
To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised if the Alexander mod just is hard-coded to knots for MacCready, because otherwise it could be complicated, but you will see. You will find out.
Yeah. Well, my goal is to survive this anyway, so...
Yeah.
I'll take my time.
Five minutes until we go, right? No, 15.
Correct. I have to say, the JS3 really is nice in a thermal.
Times really well, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Yeah, this cloud over here is really strong.
Yeah, I noticed the way you're going up, heading up, right?
Yeah. Shame I have to lose all that altitude again for the start.
I know, that's the trouble, isn't it? Wow, it is strong where I am.
Strong, but it's not too large though.
That's why GS3 is nice, because it does nice tight turns. That's 10 minutes to go. To go IFR, I think, if I go any higher.
I can see Ken, I don't see you anywhere.
Hello.
You good?
Thank you.
Wall to wall and treetop tall.
Hey, Eva, how you going?
Good stays.
Good to see that you could make it.
Thank you.
That's 5 minutes to go.
Stirring, Sam. Are you losing water or do you have smoke on?
I don't see any water from him. I do actually.
I've seen it for a while. He doesn't have that much water with him.
I think the AS-33 has a smoke feature.
Don't think so.
Depends what's going on inside the cockpit.
2 minutes.
Right. He's smoking.
And a reminder, it's 4,000 feet maximum at start.
Roger the 4K.
Three, two, one. You may stop now. Good luck, everybody.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Good luck. You too.
I'm started way too low. 3,200. I was controlling my high speed and didn't look at the altitude.
Oops.
That's right, there's a good lift up here on this ridge.
Yep.
Rush hour traffic.
Thank you.
This is not good. I can read 2023 Google on the textures.
That means they're flying too low.
Unfortunately, they're pretty big.
What are you using for mapping?
Yeah, I'm using the Google Map Pro.
Yeah, I'm using Apple Maps, and they're very good.
Yeah, it depends. It depends on the region.
Yeah. I usually always check before the flight on the websites.
Yeah.
Google Maps.
Last week's task, the Apple Map Pro were so much better than the Google Map one. I tested both.
Hmm. I don't remember.
That's a lot of use.
I'm using Map Pro.
Which one, the Apple or the Google one?
It's not neither.
Okay.
It's actually called Map Box Pro from the drop down.
Got it.
Super accurate around my local flight club.
Is it a pay app or pay service?
Yeah, I think it's under $30 for a year.
Got it.
I found a accurate for where my real life club was at Ballerina in Northern Ireland. Sorry, that's Apple Maps, I mean.
Yeah, it's all about the maps. I hope when they come out with 2024 that they really work on that as well.
I think they're very limited to using Bing Maps due to the Microsoft relationship.
Yeah, we'll just use our importer tool and get some improved as time goes on.
Yeah, I mean, stuff.
Just hope this map still works with 24, but I'm sure it will.
Some of the stuff they were showing in the trailer, like the canyon flying and all that stuff, it looked amazing, the environment. So I wonder if they did it for this particular area of the mission, or if they were able to develop a system that will dress all the hillsides and all that stuff. So, to be determined.
That's a very good question.
I think that canyon that we saw there in the trailer with the low flight training, that's definitely updated elevation data and aerial imagery, of course. But I wouldn't expect that level of detail on a global scale. Some of the areas were obviously handcrafted in the trailer.
Yes.
Like that mountain rescue thingy where you could see the 3D rocks and all that. That's not going to be everywhere.
Yeah, those might be some of the preset tasks you can try and run.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's probably manufactured for those missions.
Thank you.
one of those mountain ranges where the mountains get higher and higher the further you go.
Indeed.
Or somebody lucky buggies. Looks like it's down.
Again.
I think he needs to change his name. Sorry, lucky buggy, if you hear that. That must be unlucky.
Flying this terrain can be so deceptive. You think you're flying straight, but you're going up a lot and losing speed a lot.
Yes, indeed.
I just saw a shadow crossing my cockpit, looked up and saw a glider just above me.
That was me.
Interesting flight so far. Really nice maneuvering through the mountains here.
Yeah. I wouldn't call it easy.
No.
No, it's not easy. Nobody's talking that tells you something.
No, I'm focusing a lot myself.
I'll give B21 an ear battery.
Don't rush it, take your time, then it should be easy enough. The difficulty comes with trying to do it fast.
Yep, indeed.
I'd rather die trying than finish last.
I feel you.
Not advisable in real life, mind you.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Anyone in here know how to unpause your glider? I'm stuck in the air.
Hit the escape key.
Yep, did that, nothing happened.
Screen lock.
Go up to the taskbar at the top and maybe you've done that by mistake.
Maybe have your mouse cursor on the correct screen if you have two screens.
It said connection lost and then it just froze me.
But is the sim still running or are you in active pause or is it completely frozen?
No, completely frozen, but I can still see you guys' numbers moving, so.
That's
a bit annoying. think I'm done here, but I'll pass guard into a sleuth at some point. Lid.
Or did you hit Y for sleuth?
Yeah, I just checked that. No, I didn't.
Can you do anything in your sim? Can you bring up the toolbar? Can you do anything?
Yeah, I can do everything like that. I just can't move anything like in my glider. It's weird.
Sounds like active pause.
How do I unactive pause? Is it?
So you mean the glider's flying, but you don't have control with your joystick and stuff like that?
No, it's just fully frozen.
Maybe you activated slew mode or something.
I think it's a bright key, you know, like it's a screen lock, or bright or print screen or something for active pause.
You can just disable active pause by toggling the toolbar up in the center and then clicking the pause icon.
Yeah, no, it's unpaused.
I think you're in slew mode. So try pressing.
Yeah, I've just tried that.
Man, it's hard to say.
Yeah, well, I think that's me done. Bit disappointing, but oh well.
If you press escape, you can't bring up the menu or anything, or.
Yep. No, I can bring up the menu.
You can bring up the menu. Okay, so it's not the sim that's frozen, it's just that you're in some kind of pause state.
Did you go
which is either
the...
active pause or slew mode.
Were you able to go up to the toolbar, you know, that goes across the top, and go on, does active pause on that?
Yeah, no, I just pressed that, didn't work. My sim just crashed anyways. Might have been something to do with that.
Alright, here we go.
Anyway, cheers boys for the half of a good flight, not even half. I'll give it another 10 later.
Restart back.
Nah, I got things to do, sadly. I'm going to a motocross event this morning, so I gotta go prep my bike.
Well, you could try it some other time, anyway, with the conditions.
Yeah, no. I definitely will. Anyway, cheers boys.
Cheers.
Yep. Have a good one, man. See you next week. Cheers.
Maybe I'll have to concentrate on this again. Hello, Fabian Coffin.
since we moved to that Southeast Asia server, we never had any problems anymore. That was a good call.
Yeah, really. Still, on some odd occasions, somebody has a problem, but not nearly as much as before.
Yeah.
Good to see you back, Ken. It's really nice that we're able to stick together, though.
Yeah.
Well, most of you are a bit behind.
Thank you.
But it's definitely going very quiet around here.
I'm trying not to exceed Vinny. Anybody in here who is not planning on getting Flight Sim 24?
Are you kidding?
I assume we're all getting it the day comes out.
Silly question.
A little shocked by the negative reaction.
Yeah, me too.
Well, a lot of it comes down to the fact that they said they will support flights in 2020 for 10 years. So yeah, the new features will be in 24. I don't know how much of it will be added to 2020 still. But I mean, we all want the platform to develop. So whether that's on a new title or this title, I don't care. I don't mind paying for it, as long as it's a progress.
Exactly.
I clocked more than 2,000 hours easily on this game for $160 whenever I paid it 4 years, 3 years ago. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Can you imagine what it costs them for the service to run it as well?
Yeah, I know. It's just, I don't know why people are complaining about the... Yeah.
There's a large group of younger people who play this game, right? Can't afford it, you know.
Well,
still, no reason to complain, but...
They'll still be able to stay on 2020, so yeah. You know.
But they'll be jealous at the same time that other people have the new stuff that they want for free, that's all.
They probably buy a new copy of FIFA every year.
I wonder how long the next Xbox is ready to drop.
I just really hope to see some weather improvements.
Yeah.
I wonder. That's a big question. How's that going to impact the glider stuff that we're already acquainted with?
I want a thermal in a tornado. In VR, in a motion sim.
Could rewrite the Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, I see what you mean about be careful about V&A, but it's quite bumpy. It's very easy to go with V&A.
Yeah.
Hopefully DX12 won't be labeled beta anymore.
What's the beta?
Beta. You know, right now DX12, it's always labeled as DX12 beta.
Yes, I know what you mean. I say, what's the beta and it will still be?
I didn't quite get what you were asking. Sorry, Chaz.
So it's just saying it maybe will still be labeled beta?
I hope not. I hope that we can fully take advantage of DX12, such as ray tracing and all that goodness, you know?
Oh, well, exactly.
I'd say that's why they have to bring out a new platform, like a new weather model, new flight models if they need that, and better graphics would be new base code.
So is there any lift on this last leg?
Well, you're hitting some ridges with the tailwind. I was wondering if it's worth going over the plains and getting a cloud thermal, but probably just best thing is fly en route and take what you get.
Yeah,
I suppose.
Yeah,
I'm following the group ahead of me.
Maybe you can do some landscaping with your glider.
Minus 4,000 feet to the waypoint, but I think that will come down quickly. 70 kilometers to go.
Well, I'm
at
down
some
to
point.
4,000 now, so I might have a problem.
I expect to fly, at some point, fly to the right in a valley, get some lift, probably. Anyone getting the Meta Quest 3 when it comes out later this year?
Not me.
Nobody?
Sticking with the arrow.
You getting an arrow?
No, I'm sticking with it. That's just that.
Ah, you have an arrow. Nice.
Yeah, I have an arrow, yeah. I've had an arrow since it came out, so it's going to be almost 2 years. And I won't switch until they come with a version 2 of it, though. I'm not going to go into any other brands.
I sent my G2 in for service last week, and they updated the status that it'll be shipped back July 31st.
Wow. Wow, what was wrong with it?
was overheating, I think, is the issue. The one eye was shutting off, and then the other, and then it would just shut down. It started last Saturday during the flight.
Very well.
I was 50 days past warranty, but by the end of the call, he somehow it came through as going in under warranty, so that was a good thing.
Anybody have a crystal yet?
Not yet.
Major Dad does. He's really happy with it. Came from the Quest 2.
I've got 3 4K 50-inch screens.
I've only got
one. Doesn't compare to VR, though.
They need 4K in both eyes on these things. I got a VR set to a G2.
There's a big cloud over a ridge that should be working as well. That looks very promising where Henry is right now. Definitely heading there.
Probably be gone by the time I get there.
Even though the ridge is not at the perfect angle, I have to say. Andre has moved on, so probably not worth it.
I tell you, those trees will mess you up on the ridge.
I thought trees didn't affect the ridge yet, no?
Still shouldn't crash into them.
No, that's not a good idea.
Thank you.
Where's Henry going?
I think I'll pass the waypoint, WP3 now.
Oh, is he? Oh yeah, that explains it. Need 3,200 for the finish line.
Is that an altitude restriction?
Nope.
You have to be above 0 AGL.
Yeah, ideally.
Going over some of those ridges, you don't half get turbulence on the other side.
And I died.
What?
Yeah, I found myself in a sinkhole and couldn't get out of it, and then I tried to get altitude and I stalled. Boy! Fourth time in a row, man.
running back.
I'm starting to realize there's a lot of beach on the last leg. So probably not worth wasting a lot of time here getting altitude.
Yeah, Ian did mention that there was beach that may be able to use.
Thank you. So calm over the water.
I guess I'm left at that last ridge before the waypoint 3.
I don't see the beach doing any miracles for the guys ahead of me though. Clayton is getting a bit low. 1600 feet.
You guys crossed the water, or you stayed on that little strip of land?
I took a little shortcut over the water, but I don't know if that was a good idea. I'm moving over to the strip now.
Thank you.
I set my MacReady to 2 knots, then I do have the finish height.
You all disappeared. They reappeared. George, Henry, and Clayton disappeared at the same time.
Call me Joe is on my heels.
Yes, I am.
Getting more lift here than I was getting on the ridges. Very punctual though.
Quite a bit of sink over that jungle there on the last leg, the last bit. Don't overtake me, Joe. Nice finish, Joe.
Thank you. I stay out on the map and the speed. Nothing else.
Is there any left above the land when you get across the water?
It's very punctual, so, but you're not sinking mad.
I've got 42 to go and I'm plus 20 feet.
Is it me, or are all the gliders that landed are 808s?
I think you're right.
That's funny.
JS3 on the way in. Is the finish line right on the runway?
Yep.
Nice barking.
One final.
I'm still 7 minutes out, but no need to wait for me, guys. I know it's late. A lot of you guys are in Europe.
No worries. It was a good flight. Next week, it's my turn to create a task. And I think we'll fly the one that I've tested today. Starting in Poland, heading into Slovakia. It was a really, really nice flight. I hope you will like it too.
Ridges, thermal combo?
It's a combo.
Okay. Another one probably where I won't make it alive, so.
You will, trust me. You had your share of bad luck now.
I don't know if it's bad luck or bad flying, you know, bad skills.
They make poor decisions. Yeah.
It's bad decisions, actually.
Sometimes I just follow the wrong person.
I don't know why I'm seeing a lot of Barons. I've not seen any 808s for some reason.
What are you seeing?
I'm not seeing any DGs. I'm just all Barons. Oh. For some reason, that's, I have the 808s installed, and this is the haven't got something installed or something else, or does it not work with some of the add-ons?
But usually you see gliders, right?
No, actually I haven't been recently.
Did you enable this setting when that says use generic aircraft in multiplayer? I think you need to turn that off if you haven't yet.
Right, okay, that might be it. Well, I see one glider. I see a... What is it? Not too sure.
I see all gliders.
Can't even switch my instrument panel on yet, but someone's in front of me.
Wow. Which glider is that?
Well, at least I finished. It wasn't the best time, but I finished anyway. 1:46:36.
You finished and survived. That's what counts.
Yeah,
and it's not a race.
Definitely.
Not sure if I agree with B21, that's an easy task, mind you.
I almost gave up twice. Scraping my way into the valley.
I think we must put a few comments in, might have. So you say, Georg, you turn generic light labels off, is that what it is?
Yes. On the Discord, Cal, VR Simmer has posted a screenshot of the setting. Basically everything that says use generic models, turn that off. And then turn traffic variety to ultra. And if you want, you can also turn multiplayer aircraft in close proximity to off. That helps at the start when everybody spawns in at the same time. You don't see other cockpits within your cockpit.
Sorry, what was that one, actually?
It's all in the same settings. What is it?
Traffic.
Yeah. At the very bottom, if you scroll down, you will have four settings that are quite important. All the things that says generic aircraft models, turn that off. There's a screenshot on the Discord in the thread of the task from Cal VR Simmer.
Yeah, I thought I had done most of those, but I must just double check things. Yeah, I've got use generic aircraft models AI off, multiplayer off, and show multiple aircraft in close proximity on, traffic variety low. Right, folks, I'm away. See you next week or Wednesday. Bye.
Yeah. Me too. See you guys. All right. Thanks for joining.
Same here. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.
See you, everyone. Thanks. Thank you.